Hey everybody, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Now for the past few decades, heart disease and strokes and heart attacks are the number one cause of death around the world. And sadly, this also affects both sides of my own family, heart attacks on my mom's side and strokes on my dad. Now there's lots of, you know, reasons that may cause a heart attack or stroke, whether it's high cholesterol or maybe high blood pressure or blood sugar or maybe even hormonal imbalances typically. However, the bottom line and a common denominator is always poor blood flow circulation. However, the good news is that there are about 10 crucial symptoms that tend to occur within 30 days of having a heart attack or stroke. Now, what's important is that you pay attention to your body's natural warning signs so you can help avoid a heart attack or stroke, and that's what I'll be discussing today. Now, the first is body weakness. Now, about a month before, unusual body weakness is a key symptom resulting from the lack of blood flow and circulation. Due to the narrowing of the arteries, weakened muscles are a red flag when it comes to anticipating a heart attack or its premature state. The next is dizziness. When there is a lack of blood flow, dizziness is another symptom that shouldn't be taken lightly. The lack of proper circulation affects the blood flow to the brain, which can result in uncomfortable dizzy spells. Next one is cold sweats and excessive perspiration. You know, following dizziness, experiencing cold sweats is another signal that your body may be under duress, under extra stress. So without adequate blood flow, your body may feel, you know, clammy or cold or just generally unwell. Now, unusual or excessive sweating is also that early warning sign of a heart attack, and it might occur at any time of the day or night. Next is just chest pain and tightness. Now, if you're experiencing chest pain or pain in other areas of your body, such as your arm or your back and shoulders, you'll want to seek medical attention as soon as possible. You see, chest pain and chest tightness are key symptoms to acknowledge in order to prevent a life-threatening heart attack. Next are cold or flu symptoms. Now, many heart attack victims also have experienced cold or flu symptoms a month prior to their illness. Now, this is a good indication of, you know, your health, and it shouldn't be overlooked. Next is, again, body weakness, mainly just fatigue, overall weakness. That constant fatigue is just another strong indicator that your body's undergoing a lack of blood supply. You're just really tired all the time. And in this case, your body's just experiencing discomfort and overexertion, again, due to the fact that it's working a lot harder to generate sufficient blood flow. Again, just making your bed can seem exhausting. Next is shortness of breath. Now, shortness of breath is another key symptom to note when predicting a possible heart attack. And this is because with every muscle, it requires oxygen and adequate blood flow. Your lungs are no different. So when your heart is under distress, your lungs will naturally be affected and typically show signs through a difficulty in breathing. Next are abdominal pain or indigestion. You know, other vital signs include nausea, indigestion, heartburn, or abdominal pain. Again, due to poor blood flow, the nutrients aren't being absorbed properly, leading to stomach discomfort. Next is insomnia. You see, insomnia also is associated with an increased risk of heart attack or strokes, and this is a decrease in oxygen levels, right? Again, due to poor blood flow, which can trigger subtle changes, which can lead to anxiety, insomnia, and just agitation that can't be explained by normal circumstances. Now, people who had a heart attack often realize afterwards that they actually began to experience anxiety and sleep problems in that month before the attack. Next and finally is just changes in the thinking and just remembering. You see, we all become forgetful at times, right? Especially as we get older. However, if you've noticed a dramatic worsening of memory or for some odd reason, right? It's most likely, again, due to lack of oxygen to your brain due to poor circulation. Now, keep something in mind. I'm sure we all feel some of these symptoms daily or maybe weekly, right? Whether it's insomnia or poor memory or indigestion or fatigue. However, you're feeling some of these at a more severe level, right? Continuously for a few days in a row, just listen to your body, right? If you sense something is wrong, just go to the doctor and get it checked out. If you don't get the answers you're looking for, listen, visit another doctor. You see, because my dad had been paying close attention the day of his stroke, he made a 95% recovery. We kind of caught it really quickly. However, had he been more mindful during the previous weeks and been paying attention to what I discussed today, we could have prevented the stroke altogether. And that's the key to long-term health, prevention. Because of this, I suggest you take a look at one of the most powerful anti-aging solutions that can help you avoid a heart attack or stroke. And it's actually what my own father has been using since his stroke and what my mom uses daily to keep her blood flow healthy. Now you can just click the link below in the description area and get all the details and actually watch the next video. Well, I hope this video gave you more clarity. If you found it helpful, you know, leave your questions below. Also, do me a big favor and post what you've learned today below so other people can learn as well. And don't forget to tell a friend about today's video so you can share the health and maybe help them prevent a heart attack or stroke. As always, thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.